Is infiltration improved by cover crops? In this video, Dr. Tyson Raper with the University of Tennessee Institute of Agriculture will discuss his research.
Water infiltration and soil water holding capacity are two major issues in the upper mid-south, and they're particularly bad issues in West Tennessee. Even in the furrow irrigation system, after a furrow irrigation event, we have issues moving water down really below 6 inches. In West Tennessee, it's common practice to apply less than 3/10 of an inch of water through a pivot, because if you apply more than that, you'll see unacceptable levels of runoff. One of the easiest ways to increase infiltration and soil water holding capacity is to incorporate a cover crop into the system. This is going to increase the number of macro and micro pores. It's also going to create a physical structure on the top of the soil to intercept that rainfall and move it into the profile instead of allowing it to move off the landscape very quickly. Cotton Incorporated sponsored a project in 2015. We compared fallow plots to plots drilled to wheat as a cover crop. This trial was on an eroded hillside with 3 to 5% slopes. Now, during the season, we found several interesting trends. First, there was a 6 to 8% increase in volumetric water content where cover crops had been planted. Additionally, the sensors in the cover crop responded to very light rainfall events, which sensors in the fallow areas did not log. Finally, we increased our lint yields by 111 pounds per acre. These research findings further supported our theories that cover crops increase water holding capacity and infiltration rates.
So, will these research findings hold water in a farm setting? West Tennessee producer Matt Griggs has been experimenting with cover crops for several years.
I'm starting to see a huge difference in my water infiltration rates. I've got some side-by-side plots I've been doing in conjunction with NRCS that we're on our third year. The plots go slightly downhill, and I went out there in the middle of the rainstorm after I think it had been about two and a half inches of rain had fallen, and stood right in between two plots, cover crops on the right, no-till on the left. And on the left, the no-till, I mean, you see the water just flowing down. On the right, right next to it, no water. It's all soaking in the ground.
A few counties away, cotton producer Barry Lake has also seen improvements in water infiltration.
Cover crops have helped us a lot. Like I say, it helps on the water holding capacity, and I thought about putting irrigation in several years ago, but by using the cover crops, I think we're getting better yields without having to spend the extra money to put in the irrigation system. And the cover crops are probably cheaper in the long run, and even though your seed cost is sort of high on your cover crops, your water cost for your irrigation rig will run you a good bit of money too.
You know, here in West Tennessee, we get ample rainfall for the year. We get 52 inches. We just don't always get it at the right time. So we get in July, August, when we're trying to fill bowls on cotton or grain fill and soybeans and corn. If I can soak up an extra half inch or an inch during a rainstorm, that could be the difference between a break even or even losing money.